Wow, that was a fun song. I love upbeat music.
Me too. Makes me want to dance.
Maybe not now.
You're right. Hello, and welcome to the 2017 CCA Talent Show. My name is Jacoby.
And I'm Jeremiah.
And we're your MCs. We have a lot of exciting acts tonight.
First up, we have Daniela Trejo and Rebecca Moore doing a gymnastics routine to the song Happy, made popular by Pharrell Williams.
Take it away, ladies.
Might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break.
Next we have, we have a problem.
What?
The next performer forgot their name when they were signing up for this talent show. See, it says, I don't know my name. How will we announce them?
Jeremiah, that's the name of the song. The song is called I Don't Know My Name.
Oh, right.
Next we have Deborah Jordan playing the ukulele and singing I Don't Know My Name by Grace Vanderwell.
Don't play by
by the rules of the game, so you say. I'm just trying. I win from plans and pop. You learn to join in the marching band. I made the closest friends I'll ever have in my lifetime. I'm lost, trying to be found in an ocean of people. I don't know my name. I don't play by the rules of the game, so you say. I'm just trying. I now know my name. I don't play by the rules of the game, so you say. I'm just trying, but I'm trying to find my way.
Deborah, your name is Deborah.
Next, we have someone who doesn't have any trouble remembering her name. In fact, she's great at remembering things.
Reciting two whole chapters from the Book of Psalms, give it up for Abigail Chinapa.
My name is Abigail Chinapa, and today I will be reciting Psalm 23 and Psalm 121. Here is Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Here is Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He shall not suffer thy foot to be moved. Behold, he that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shield upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore.
Next up, we have the two kings of comedy themselves.
Please welcome to the stage Mordecai Jordan and Andrew Shadburn.
If at first you don't succeed, you and me have a lot in common. Okay, my name is Mordecai.
I'm Andrew. And we're going to be telling you guys some jokes today. I have a great feeling about this.
Okay, but first let's go over some ground rules. Okay, rule number one
is, if you don't want to laugh, don't laugh. Please. Some of these jokes you might not find funny, Joe, so if you don't want to laugh, don't feel forced.
Don't feel forced to laugh if you don't want to. Only laugh if you really, really, really think it's funny. Okay, so that's the only rule. Let's get started. So the other day I went to the grocery store to go and get a gallon of milk. So I go get my gallon of milk, and then I go to check out. And the lady at the checkout line asks me, she says, would you like your milk in a bag? And I said, no, you can just leave it in the carton. It might kind of make a mess if you put it in the bag.
So, I have a question for you. What do you call a fat psychic? A fortune teller.
Really? Those are the kind of jokes you prepared?
So, we all know the old saying.
Jeez Louise, Andrew.
So, you all know the old saying, if you can't beat them, join them. My saying is, if you can't beat them, beat them. Because then they'll be expecting you to join them, and then you'll have the element of surprise.
That's a thinker. Okay, everybody might not have caught that one, so let's slow it down and do a slower joke for some of the slower people in the audience. I wondered why the baseball was getting bigger. Then it hit me. Get it? The baseball was getting bigger because it was coming towards me. Am I right?
So one of the things I wonder about is why they decided to make a day 24 hours long. I think they just stayed up for about 24 hours and then they said, let's just call it a day.
You know, I'm actually pretty tired right now. I stayed up all night trying to find out where the sun went. And then it dawned on me.
You know, I saw Will Smith last winter.
You saw Will Smith last winter? What was he doing?
Following some Fresh Prince.
Fresh Prince, like in the snow? Is the microphone on? I think, guys, I don't think they heard the joke. All right, whatever, we'll move on. Okay. Speaking of snow, it's freezing in here. I went over to the corner earlier, but it's just as cold over there. And to think they taught me in school that corners are supposed to be 90 degrees.
So you know in algebra when you have to find the X. Okay, never mind. And the only person who actually needs to find an X is the pirate.
Okay, I got a question. How did the dentist become a brain surgeon?
How?
His hand slipped. Ooh, yikes. I know. Okay, you know, when they announced this talent show, I told everybody I was going to do comedy. And everybody just laughed at me. But look how far I've made it. Nobody's laughing now. See?
So when I first heard about auditions for the talent show, I thought I would recite poetry. But I also wanted to do comedy, so I decided to merge the two. A day without sunshine is like night.
So that's when we decided to do comedy together. You know, teamwork is very important. It helps to shift the blame if something goes wrong.
So, you know, Mother's Day is coming up. It's in, like, soon. And I was going to give my mom what she really wanted for Mother's Day. But you have to be 18 to move out, and I'm 13.
Whoa, you're right. Mother's Day is coming up. You know, my mom always tells me to eat carrots because they're good for your eyesight. And at first I didn't believe her, but then again, have you guys ever seen a bunny rabbit who has to wear glasses? Nope, I don't think you have.
Okay, so I have a riddle for you guys. A man gave up his seat on a bus for a blind woman. Then a few hours later, he got fired from his job. What was his job? The bus driver.
Hold on, what? What the heck? Hold on. If you're dressed like a banana and you're eating a banana, isn't that cannibalism? Okay, I don't know why you guys are clapping, because that joke is not funny at all. But how else are you supposed to transition to a banana on the stage?
Speaking of bananas, what did the banana say to the elephant?
What did the banana say to the elephant?
Nothing. Bananas can't talk, stupid.
Bruh.
So we got time for about one more joke.
Okay, one more joke? I got this one. Okay. When I eat tacos, I eat them over a tortilla. So when stuff falls out, boom, another taco.
now I get it. I told you, this isn't the time for dancing.
Sure it is.
You're right. Next, we have Maggie Rowell doing a lyrical dance routine to the song Satellite by Dave Matthews.
Next, we have an exciting duet from our 2 fourth graders.
Singing You Belong With Me by Taylor Swift, Gabrielle Sanders, and Isabella Rayberg.
Looking for has been here the whole time. If you can see that I'm the one who understands you, been here all
Well, watching these kids have inspired me. I thought back to my childhood. What is it that I would have done had I been in third, fourth, fifth grade? And so I thought back in my childhood and thinking, what did I teach myself? Actually, it was, how many of you remember Highlights Magazine? All right, Highlights Magazine, the little magazine that used to come home, and it had Goofus and Gallant, and it had different things in there. And one summer, it came in at June, and it said, I'm going to teach you how to juggle. So that's what I thought would be kind of fun, to bring back what I taught myself as a nine-year-old years ago. All right, so I'm going to teach you how to juggle tonight, just like Highlights Magazine taught me. So it said, get a round ball. So I've got a ball here. You can pick one up anywhere, really, but any kind of tennis ball would work. And it said, just throw this up and down over and over and over again. And when people do this, they call that juggling. Then use two hands. Ooh, this is pretty exciting. Are you bored yet? All right, so then it says, after about 2 weeks of doing that over and over thousands of times, take two balls and throw one up and pass it like this. And I would do this for like 1,000 times a day until I could be comfortable not even paying attention. And then you could do this. Ooh. You do this for a couple of weeks. Now I'm in the week of maybe the third or fourth week of July. And then it says, now pull out the third one. Now, before you can do three, you've got to be very comfortable with two. And so you've got to be able to do this. And then move to this. After a while, see this little space here, and then you can do it really big. And it's very difficult to actually do this with the lights because all I see is the shadow of the ball. But then over about the end of August, right before school was going to start, I said, you know, I want to do a fancy trick. I want to see if I can get it under my leg. So, but my teacher, when I got back to school in September, said, well, you can't play with those in class. So I got a little more creative because we were allowed to have snacks. So I said, what if I just bring my snacks? And is it snack time? Yes. And I would just bring out three. Now, if you know anything about me, red apples are not my favorite. I don't like red apples. I like green apples. Is there anybody in the house likes green apples? Yes, all five of you. Thank you. All right, no, the children like them. And then you got an orange. Well, I thought, what if I could juggle the three fruit, and then it's snack time, I could eat it while I'm juggling. Well, this is kind of exciting, but you don't want to eat the wrong one. I don't want to eat this one. It's nasty. I don't think I can even try to eat this one, But we'll see. And then this is the one I want. So I would be, okay, yes, Mrs. Smith, I'm just practicing during snack time. It's okay. I can't even see what the colors are in these things here. The lights are too bright. Oops. Hold on. Sometimes in juggling, you do drop them. Let's see if I can do this again. Okay, what? I'm trying to figure out the color. I really cannot see the color. It's so close. All right. All right. So, the older I got, I had to determine what I wanted to play. I loved baseball. Does anybody like baseball? I love baseball. But I also love football. Anybody like football? I played football and baseball all the way through high school. Offered a football scholarship and a baseball scholarship to two different universities. Not big time schools, but enough to pay my education. Ended up choosing not to go there because I wanted to be a pastor. Excuse me. The apple's hard to go down. One sport I never did play, and I don't understand it, is soccer. Anybody like soccer? And then I thought, if I could learn how to juggle three sports, wouldn't that be awesome? So, the difficult part is that the space has to be much bigger because the balls are much bigger. But maybe you can get them into a small space. Or, let's see here. All right. So as a 9-year-old, I was learning how to do that. Having no idea, it was really preparing me for life. How many of you adults are juggling a lot of stuff? Once in a while, you may drop something. But if you'll keep your eye on the ball and keep the most important things in sight, yes, you're juggling family, you're juggling friends, you're juggling work, juggling a lot of other things. Most important thing you have in your life is that what's sitting in this room. Your family and your faith. Keep those things important, and everything else will come into line. Thank you.
Right, not wrong, our minds grew strong. Now we're singing this fun song, L-U-O.
hope you enjoyed Act 1 of the CCA Talent Show.
There will be a 15-minute intermission. Enjoy your break, and we'll see you in Act 2.
Thank you. Pharisee, you came for hypocrites, even more like me. You carried sin and shame, the guilt of every man, the weight of all I've done, nailed into your hand. Oh, your love bled for me. Oh, your blood in crimson streams. Oh, your death is hell's defeat. A cross meant to kill is my victory. I've seen and tasted it. It's running through my veins. I can't escape its grip. In you my soul is safe. You cover everything. Oh, your love bled for me. Oh, your blood in crimson. Us alive again, makes us alive again.
Thank you.
Welcome back. We're excited to start Act Two. Jacoby, are you okay?
I think I might have a fever. A frozen fever, that is.
Oh, I get it. You're trying to introduce the next act.
Exactly. Next, we have Hadassah Jordan and Maggie Rowell singing Making Today a Perfect Day from Disney animated short Frozen Fever.
It has to be perfect. Elsa? You've never had a real birthday before, except of course the ones you spent outside my locked door. So I'm here way too late to help you celebrate and be your birthday date, if I may. Elsa, I'm thinking you might have a cold. I don't get colds. Besides, a cold never bothered me anyway. Just follow the things. I've got big plans, I've got surprises for today. Nothing but nothing's gonna get in our way. I've worked 4 weeks, planned everything within my power. I even got Kristoff and Sven to take a shower. If someone wants to hold me back, I'd like to even try. I'm on the perfect planet back. I'm giving you the sun, the moon, and the sky. Making the day a perfect day for you. Making the day a blast if it's the last thing I do. Everything you are to me and all you've been through. So make the day a birthday for you. Ooh.
Achoo! Achoo! They come in threes.
I'm fine.
Achoo!
Surprise, surprise, this one's especially.
Achoo!
Wow, you got me reeling, but I'm so concerned for you. I think it's time that you go home and get some rest. We are not stopping, cause the next one is the best. Elsa, you gotta go by now.
The way we have to paint the town.
But you need medical attention.
Are you sick? Have I the cold remedy of my own invention?
No thanks,
we'll take it.
I'm gonna make it today, a perfect day for you.
Make it today, a special day. I love you too.
So we're making today a perfect day. Say everybody, you're making today a perfect day.
Come on, now we climb.
No, Elsa, that's too much. You need to rest.
No, we need to get to our birthday chills. I mean thrills. Making dreams, making plans. Go, 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 go. Follow the things to the end. You're my very best friend.
Elsa?
What? I'm fine. We're gonna climb. We're gonna sing. Follow the strings to the thing. Happy, 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 merry, 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 happy, happy.
Elsa, you're burning up. You've got a fever.
Come on, you can't go on like this. Let's put this day on hold. Come on, admit it to yourself.
Okay, I have a cold. I'm sorry, Anna. I just wanted to give you one perfect birthday, but I ruined it again.
You didn't ruin anything. Let's just get you to bed.
Surprise!
Wow!
Wow!
We're making today a perfect day for you. We're making today a smiling face so shiny and new. We're flying
bed with you.
No, 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 wait. All that there's left to do is for the queen to blow the birthday bugle.
No, no, no. Come on, let's go to bed.
What's wrong now, Jacoby?
Disney songs just get to me.
Well, try to pull it together, because we've got to announce our next act.
Okay, I'll try. Next up, we have Barnabas Jordan doing...
Let's just go. Feeling better, Jacoby?
Yes, nothing like like some Disney comedy to lift my spirits.
Next, we have a very interesting act.
Here's Nald Melz from giving a presentation about Ethiopia.
My name is Nad. I'm from Ethiopia. Today I'm wearing Ethiopian clothes. We normally wear this every Sunday or every holiday. Ethiopia is located in East Africa. The capital is Addis Ababa. There are a lot of foods like lentil, beef stew, and flatbread. My favorite is flatbread. In Ethiopia, they have a lot of religions like Islam, Ethiopian Orthodox, and Catholic. My religion is Orthodox. Orthodox means Christian, and I am a Christian. Ethiopian distance runner Abba Bekele was the first black African to win the gold medal in the Olympics, barefooted. The oldest skeleton in Ethiopia is the name is Lucy. The Ethiopian calendar is different than the American calendar. I will teach you 5 words in Ethiopia. Salam means hi. Now repeat after me. Salam. Kwal means girl. Now repeat after me. Kwal. Ababa means flower. Then repeat after me. Ababa. Makina means car. Now repeat after me. Makina. Chow means bye. Now repeat after me. Chow. Chow.
Up next, we have another Taylor Swift act.
Oh man, no way. I didn't want to say anything before, but I'm a huge T-Swizzy fan.
Really?
Yeah, oh yeah. That's my jam. Whenever I get into any problems, I take T-Swizzy's advice and shake it off, shake it off.
Let's leave it to the professionals, Jacoby. Next up, performing Love Story by Taylor Swift, Brooklyn Moore, and Isabella Rayburg.
Be waiting. I'm feeling so alone. I keep waiting for you, but you never come. Is this in my head? I don't know what to think. He knelt to the ground and pulls out a ring and says, marry me, Juliet, you'll never have to be alone. I love you.
That love story they told was like magic.
Speaking of magic, we have a magician in our midst.
Please welcome to the stage the great Jacob Rowell and his wonderful assistant, Malat Tesfaye.
Okay, so today I'm going to be doing some magic for you guys, as you heard by the MCs. The first trick I'm going to do is the magic ball through the cup trick. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take, here, hold this, these three balls right here. I'm going to take them and place them on the table. And now when I place these cups down, I'm going to place the middle one on the middle ball on the middle cup. I'm going to cover the cups like that, and when I hit it, the ball will go through the one cup. And watch, as I do it again, it'll appear that there will be two balls there. So now I'm gonna do some classic card tricks. Well, not classic, just card tricks. Okay. So, take these cards right here. Shoot, okay. I gotta take one, two, three, two, three. Just 1 second. Okay. Okay, and done. So you see I have these four aces. Four of them. Four aces? You see it? Okay. So now I'll close this box and watch. These aces are gonna act like bank robbers. So the first ace is gonna go to the first floor of the bank. And the second ace is gonna go to the second floor of the bank. And the third ace is gonna go to the third floor. And the fourth ace is gonna stay at the top as a getaway. So now when I snap my fingers, all the aces will come to the top because the cops came. Okay, now, for my next trick, I will need a volunteer. Someone that knows how to shuffle. Okay, so Malat, will you pick someone that knows how to shuffle, please? Okay, so what I need you to do is just shuffle this deck of cards so everyone knows that they're all shuffled. Okay, what's your name?
Grace.
Oh, give it up for Grace. Okay, so now that everyone knows they're all shuffled, I'm going to take a card and place it on the table. And so it's an ace. I'm going to count until king, even if it's not the card I say. And I'm going to do that six times. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king, and then do it 5 more times, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king, queen, king, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king. That's an ace, so I'm going to run out of cards, so I have to do it again. Oh my gosh. But they'll still be shuffled. Sorry about that. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king. King. 2, 3, wait. Jack, queen, king. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king. So now I need another volunteer, just anyone from the audience. Anyone from the audience? Somebody raise their hand. I just need you to pick 3 of these decks. Just tap them. Tap any 3.
That one.
Okay.
That one.
Okay.
And that one.
So I'm gonna turn these 3 decks over, the ones that you said, and and put these cards back in this deck. So now what I need you to do is tap 2 of these decks. And I'm going to turn these cards over and give it up for Miss Maggie. Okay, so now I'm going to lay down 10 cards face down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And add 7 cards because that's 4 and 3 together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now, the number of these cards will be the remaining cards, the number of these cards will be the amount shown on this top card right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I failed! How did that happen? The only reason that happened was because there's 1 more card that I didn't get out. Well, at least I have that card now. So for the next trick, I'll be doing a pick a card trick. I need someone from the audience to pick a card. Someone from the audience. No one's raising their hand. So what I need you to do is pick a card from this, any card. Just pull it out. And now show it to the audience. I won't look. Okay, you got it? Everyone got the card? All right, everyone got it? Am I good now? Yes. Okay, so now I'll take the card, I won't look, and I'll place it back in the deck. So now I'll find the card behind my back. Okay, pretty sure I got it. Now, when I spread these cards out on the table, there'll be a card facing up. this right here. Thank you. May the fourth be with you. Here, just, no, she'll get the table.
Our next act is very unique and interesting.
We could tell you all about it, but we thought we'd let the artist himself come onto the stage.
Please give a warm welcome to DJ Britton. He has created a stop-motion film for you to enjoy, and he would like to explain his process of making it.
After that, please direct your attention to the screens and enjoy his film. Oh, okay. My name is DJ Britton. You might have already known that. Before I show you my stop-motion animation, I want to tell you how I did and how you could do it yourself. First, find any item able to move or not. Position it in a way that you would choose. Take a picture of small movements one by one each frame. And that's mainly it. Or just go to the App Store games and then find any stop-motion app you might want to play or use. And thank you for listening and enjoy my film.
Thank you.
The song Over the Rainbow was made famous in 1939 when it was sung by Judy Garland in the musical movie The Wizard of Oz.
Did you know that it won the Academy Award for the Best Original Song of the year it came out?
Cool. This song gives a message of hope and new beginnings.
Singing Over the Rainbow, the students of CCA.
The message of hope is a strong one. We here at CCA know that there is only one place our hope really comes from.
We have one final song to perform for you this evening. We pray its message of hope will speak to your hearts.
Here are the students of CCA singing the worship song, Mighty to Save.
Compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy.
Thank you for joining us tonight.
We hope you have fun. We sure did.